Hey YouTube, Anna here. I am here filming my 12-week update. This is crazy. I'm super excited. This past week has been eventful. Let's just say that. I saw Logan, which is the new Wolverine movie, in theater with my best friend, and my head was hurting so bad. It was after I got headbutted by Cece. So like it's now black, so I can't really cover it very well with like concealer, powder, foundation, all that other stuff. So sorry, my makeup was open. It was weird. Anyway, easily distracted. That should be one of my symptoms. So my head was just like throbbing, but I was just dying to like hang out outside of the house and just have like a little bit of a break. So went to go see it. It's a really good movie. Especially if you like X-Men movies or superhero movies in general. I like those types of movies. So yeah, and Hugh Jackman, I mean, come on. So my head was hurting, and my friend ordered a Dr. Pepper, and I totally drank a lot of it. I was gonna say a little, but that's a lie. I drank a lot of it. Took away my headache, and that's really the only caffeine I've had since I got pregnant. I stopped drinking caffeine like 3 days after my IUI, and I miss coffee. Like, I just miss the taste, and yeah, I just miss the whole process. I miss coffee, but I haven't had any coffee. I just had that soda. So, I mean, that's pretty good. I was like 11 weeks a couple days and I had a little bit of soda. So, I'm not gonna beat myself up over it like I would have with my pregnancy with Cecilia. I'm not perfect. I don't claim to be. But yeah, like I really stuck to the rules pretty well until I got into my second trimester, and then I had like one cup of tea, and that's sort of like what I maintained throughout my pregnancy was like one cup of tea, and I will not drink coffee, and like all that stuff. So I feel like more relaxed, and I've heard that on like different forums and stuff that women the second time around are much more relaxed. I've had cramps, I've also had nausea. I ran out of my B complex vitamin. My husband's watching her, so should be okay. She might be just upset that he took her crayons. Anyway, so I ran out of my B complex vitamin, which I was taking every day to sort of help me battle nausea, and I ran out of that in the early part of the week, and my nausea was sort of like getting more intense. And intense from before, which was nothing. So I was like, I could just notice it, was basically what I'm saying. God, I can't talk and I can't communicate. I'm really sorry, guys. I'm keeping up with the yoga and this prenatal yoga class online, which is on YouTube, is really, it can be challenging. I tried to do an hour version of like her class, and it was like kicking my butt. So I was like, gonna keep the half hour, like 30 to 40 minutes, like that's sort of where I'm comfortable right now. So I'm gonna do that. And then maybe try the 1 hour in a couple of weeks, but 1 hour was just like, my body was like, no, not gonna happen. I'm still leaking a little bit of colostrum. I haven't had any milk this past week. But I have had the weird, like, letdown symptoms, like, kind of tingly in the nipple area, which I know is TMI, but this is a, like, TTC channel, so you gotta bear with me. So it kind of felt like letdown was happening, which was kind of weird, and I just sort of paused to, like, observe it, and then I moved on. So it doesn't, like, interfere with anything. Cece had a cold this past week, which I'm not sure if it actually was a cold. It was one day, very intense, like congestion, but she slept fine through the night, and that's usually like her sign that something's wrong, is that she will not sleep through the night, which is unusual for her. So there was that one day, and then just sort of like tapering off to this like steady stream of mucus, which is gross. So we're assuming that it's allergies, because my allergies have been trying to murder my face this week. Like, just my sinuses are really irritated, and my throat is super scratchy, and my eyes are like itchy and watery. I mean, it's all of that. And my husband, like, as soon as I complained about it, my husband was like, let me look up what you can take. And we had a sheet that said you could take Zyrtec, and we had like the Sam's Club brand Zyrtec bottle that had expired, which I know it like supposed to lessen the potency of it over time, but I feel great after I take it. I take one in the morning and it's just like one a day. After I take that sucker, I am good. Like, I feel much better. I still have a little bit of like tingly in my nose and I sneeze a little bit, but it's nothing like the crazy fog that I was in like 3 days ago where I just like could not function at all. We heard the heartbeat on the Doppler at 11 weeks and 2 days. So I'm pretty good at finding the baby's heartbeat. My husband has not had good luck being the one to find the heartbeat. So usually I'll let him look for the heartbeat for a while, and then once he's like, okay, I need to just stop, I'll take over and then I'll find it. And it doesn't register on the actual Doppler because it's faint, probably because I have an anterior placenta, so it's next to my belly button. So we can hear it and we time it on the stopwatch thing, and then we just like figure that it's around 158 or 168. I think it was 168 and 170-ish. So it's sort of in that range right now. Let's see what else. I switched to sleeping with a maternity pillow. I don't know if you can see behind me. No, you can't. You can kind of see like lumps in the background. I switched to my huge U-shape maternity pillow, and it has solved, for the most part, my sleep issues, knock on wood. It's amazing. The first night that we brought it down, I was like, you know, I don't know if this is gonna work. I've been so uncomfortable, and my hip was hurting like really bad from laying on that one side. So we got it out and I slept through the night, didn't even have to get up to go pee. I will tell you one thing that's sort of a downside with the pillow is that when you do want to position or reposition yourself, it's like an event. So like I have to sit up completely and like reposition my arm and like get it through the hole and like get my arm and anyway. So it's sort of an event to get positioned the way you want to, and if you have to reposition during the night. But that being said, I'm willing to have that small inconvenience for beautiful sleep, and it gives me beautiful sleep, so I'm really happy about that. Okay, so last but not least, you guys are probably wondering about the gender reveal. Last week I was like, we're getting the results and we're gonna do a gender reveal. So none of that happened. I got a call from my OBGYN. Well, she's like my midwife, so I don't know why I said OBGYN. I got a call from my midwife's office and they said, we got a note from the Natura company, which does the Panorama blood work screening thing. And they said that your baby levels were at, your fetal percentage was too low for them to extract what they need. And so my baby levels were like 2.7%, and they needed to be 3.4% for them to actually be able to extract it and do their tests on the fetal DNA. So she's like, you may have to just go do your ultrasound to see like how the nuchal fold is developing, or you can come in to get it redrawn. And I was like, okay, I want to get it redrawn because I want to know. And they were like, okay, well, we have to check with the midwife again and just make sure that we have an extra kit for you and all that stuff. So it took them 2 days to get back to me. They got back to me on Thursday and they said, okay, there'll be a kit waiting for you. Come on in whenever. And I was like, awesome. I'll be there tomorrow. We already had plans to be down there on Friday. So I was like, this will work out perfectly. I had my teeth cleaned in the morning on Friday here in town. I had fluoride on my teeth. It was weird, you know, like gloppy and gross. I wasn't drinking a whole lot of water, which totally bit me in the butt afterwards. Because I went in, I was like, okay, I'm done with my cleaning appointment. Let's go. Like, I'm ready. Yeah. So we rushed down there early. And she poked me in the arm. She got a vial of blood. She said it was slow. And I was like, okay, I don't know what that means, but whatever. It's slow. It's a slow flow. So I was fine with it. And then she was like, oh, and your vein stopped. I was like, wow, that sucks. Like, you're gonna have to poke me again. So she poked me again on a different arm. And she's like, I can't get any blood out of that one. Let's go back to the other arm. But I know that there's this other vein in that arm that's like really good. So she went to that one and she blew my vein. Like bruised, bled a lot. It was like, yeah. And she got like drops of blood in the other one. So she's like, how are you with your liquid intake today? And I was like, oh, haven't been drinking water, like pretty bad today actually. I had my teeth cleaned and then I just didn't drink after that. So she was like, okay, your blood definitely looks like you're dehydrated. And she showed me and it was gross. And if blood grosses you out, don't listen to this part. Close your ears. Because she showed me the blood and she tilted it to the side and it was like this huge congealed mass on the side, which is like gelatinous blood and very thick and very dark. And she's like, usually when you're dehydrated, you can have, you know, very dark blood and it congeals really quick. So we need you to drink more water and come back on Monday. And I was like, but I live out of town and I'll need to talk to my husband because I don't know if that'll work with his work schedule and, you know, taking care of the baby and stuff. So I was like, what if I just like chug a ton of water and then I come back like at the end of the day, all super hydrated. Will that work? And she's like, yeah, I mean, we probably can do that. And I was like, okay, I'm hitting that water. So I was just downing. I downed 64 ounces easily within a few hours. I was chugging, chugging, chugging. I was peeing like a racehorse. I was peeing. So yeah, I was like ready. Go back in and my nurse was like, nah, I'm not gonna poke you. I'm going to have the midwife come in. She used to place IVs. She's really good at this. She's gonna poke you. So she goes into another spot near the spot that, you know, she got the blood from the first time. And she got a tube and then my vein quit on her. So they were like, sorry, we're gonna poke you again. I was like, that's fine. Like, I'm here. I'm hydrated. Like, this is gonna be okay. She pokes me and the other arm. Nothing. Doesn't get a vein at all. No blood. Then she goes back over here to my blown vein. And I said, this is vein usually gives like lots of blood. She's like, yeah, but I'm afraid it's blown. And I was like, okay, well, like you're the nurse, I don't know. or she's the midwife. So I was like, I'm not gonna argue with you. Like, fine, if it's blown, then don't do it. And she was like, well, just let me try. So she went in there and she got just a few drops of blood and then nothing. Ugh. So that one, that outer one, I'll show it to you. I don't know if you can see it from there. Oh, you can. It's pretty blown. So it bled a lot, and then she got a few drops out of my arm there, and then she tried my outer arm here, and then she tried my wrist. And I told her, like, my wrist is not good. Tried to get an IV in the hospital for my ECV. Nurse had a really hard time with it. It's not usually a good vein for me. And she's like, but I feel it. It's like right there. And she was so nice. She was so nice. And I wasn't mad that she was like missing every single vein in my body. I knew that I was a hard stick, especially for people who aren't phlebotomists. They don't do this all the time. I knew I was a hard stick. So I was trying to keep a sense of humor about it. Like, I wasn't mad. But she went for my wrist and I was like, you go for it. You do whatever you have to do. And so she got into my wrist and she was like, oh, the vein moved on me, disappeared. And I was like, dang it. So we had one vial and one like drop in the other one. And my blood looked better. It was lighter. It was free flowing. None of that gross stuff. So if you're counting, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8. 8 pokes. And yeah, so in the morning she had thrown out the first vial of blood, the really thick one. And she said, if you come back in, we'll get your 2 vials and you'll go. Well, we only got 1 vial. She already thrown out the other one. So we didn't have a complete kit. She started saying, you'll need to come back next week, all this stuff. And I was like, it's better. I know that there's a lab open on Saturday in that town. Still an hour's drive, but at least it's on the weekend and my husband's off and like we can make it a family outing if we need to, or I can go alone and not have to worry about finding a babysitter for Cecilia. So what if I took a kit to their office and had my blood drawn? And she was like, okay, let me check to see if you could keep that vial of blood, if you can have a kit outside of this setting, you know, like, let me check with all these people. So she came back and she said, sure. The people at Natura said your blood will keep just fine out of the office for a day or so. And you just take this like half used kit over to the labs to get your blood drawn into that vial of tube, the vial of blood that had just a few drops in it. So I was like, okay, we have a plan. We're going to get this done. So today, this morning, I turned 12 weeks. I'm all excited. Last night we heard the baby's heartbeat again. It was beautiful. So things are going well and I'm like, I'm getting this done. I'm super hydrated, like, yay. So we go in and they call me back and I'm like, listen, I've had an ordeal with this. And I just told her everything. 8 pokes. And she's like, yikes. I was like, in 1 vial of blood and then just a little bit in another one. And so she pulls it out and she pulls out my tubes and she said, honey, we can't redraw blood into this tube because the vacuum seal is gone. Once they stab it, it doesn't suck blood into it anymore. And I was like, what? And she's like, I'm sorry. Like, and I said, well, do you have extra tubes here that you could just like give them my blood in a different tube? And she was like, this one has a special, they have properties in the tube already that mix with your blood and start to separate it or whatever. The science behind it. So we don't carry this specific one with this specific type that is compatible with their office. And to make matters worse, they don't actually collect on the weekends at all. So you have to come back on Monday. I was like, I live an hour away. Like, This is not convenient. She's like, I'm so sorry. Let me double check. Maybe I'm wrong. And I was like, please be wrong, please be wrong. And she left and she came back and she's like, I'm sorry. You're gonna have to come back and I'll throw away your blood. And I was like, great. So somewhere out there's just like vials of my blood being disposed of right now. Ugh. So maybe it's not in the cards for me to get this panorama. I will show you again this panorama blood work kit thing done. It's been a pain in my butt. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I will probably talk to my husband about it and see what he thinks. I talked to my mother-in-law and she was so sweet. She's like, I feel terrible for you. I don't know if it would be worth it to like get your blood redrawn for the 100th time to send it in again. They've already got my blood once and they're gonna charge me for that processing. And if it happens again that I have low fetal DNA in my blood, then I have to pay for it a second time and no results. So I'm like 7 or 8 weeks actually away from my 20-week scan, my anatomy scan, which would tell me the sex of the baby then. Do I just wait? I mean, ugh. I don't know. It's a pain. It's a real pain. And I don't like needles like at all. Like you would think that I would be okay with needles just because I've had so much blood work done, having infertility issues, having all these blood draws. You think I'd be desensitized to it, but I'm not at all. Like I have to look away. I kind of have to like do some like hypnobirthing breathing to like get myself calm because I feel like crazy inside when I get my blood drawn, but I try to like keep it together. In my arm on my left side, I'm not sure which one it was, but she like jumped the needle a little bit in my arm and it hurt like bad. So I was like, oh, really quick. And she was like, I'm sorry. Oh, and I was like, that's get out of my arm. But yeah, like, we'll just see. I don't know. I don't know how I'll feel next week, but I have an appointment next Friday. That's just my normal midwife appointment. And maybe then I'll come in and I'll feel differently. Like, yes, let's do the genetic screening. Let's poke me again and all that stuff. But also, I've known, like, especially at the hospital up here, once you get deemed a hard stick, it's really hard to get a proper draw after that. So I know.